The Voices of Kentuckiana, hosted by Debbie Crawford. Music by Clay Beverly. Produced by Lynn Key.
This is Debbie Crawford with Kentuckiana News, and we're here in LaGrange, Kentucky, because some interesting things are happening at Karen's Book Barn. There are three new owners, and you are?
I'm Tony Acree.
I'm Lynn Tincher.
And if you were at the Comic-Con in Madison 2 years ago, Lynn was there. She's had a movie made. And you are a publisher on the best-selling list?
That's right. I'm owner of the award-winning Hydra Publications. And my Victor McCain thriller series has made it on the bestseller list on Amazon.
That's just awesome. So there's a lot of knowledge here at Karen's Book Barn now. And some of the things that you guys have in store for the store are, Lynn, I think you've got some cool stuff here.
Right, we're going to start some writers groups where some people can come in and get some one-on-one time with myself and Tony and Frank. Frank is our partner that used to own that book place in Madison, Indiana. So we're going to have some groups set up where we can work with writers and also some readers groups as well. We're going to be doing book signings every Saturday if we can get it, the authors in. And one of the main things we really want to do is work with local authors specifically to help facilitate their signings and be able to help do some marketing for them as well.
Well, I think with you featuring a lot of the local authors, which that's not just LaGrange. That's
right.
In our region.
You know,
if you're an author and you want to come to a book signing at Karen's Book Barn, then if you're in the region, then that's what they're considering a local author.
We have writers coming from Cincinnati, Lexington, we'll have people here from St. Louis.
Right.
So within the Nashville, we'll be up here for signings.
Oh, that's just great. Now, with the workshops that you're going to be doing, what are some of the things that you're going to really focus on with the...
Well, the great thing about particularly Lynn and myself and Frank having owned Hydra Publications before I bought it from Frank, from the novice to the established author, we'll be able to teach everybody from someone who's never written a novel, the process of writing, because there is a real process to getting a novel finished,
yes,
to actually more advanced authors knowing how to market your books, how to get in with a small press, how to approach agents. So we're going to be working a lot with children as well. So really kids and people of all ages and of all levels of expertise, because we have some unique qualities that we can offer and experiences to teach people about the art of writing and publishing a book.
Oh, that's really a treasure that we've needed in this region. I think it'll be great. I think a lot of the high school kids that have all these thoughts that are coming through their mind that they just really would love to write and they don't know how yet. So it's great for them to be.
Well, one of the real joys, I'm sure, Lynn, I do a lot of speaking at elementary schools and high schools.
Mm-hmm.
And again, I was just at the gifted summer camp at Morehead State University.
Right.
So we get to talk to young people and get them really excited about coming to a bookstore. And it's great because here's a summer camp where they can do anything in the world. They chose to go to a writing class.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to foster that here at this store.
Now, you have some specialty things that are going to be coming into the store. They're not just books.
Right, we're going to bring back some coffee at some point. We're still getting our, feet wet, so to speak, and getting the store organized the way we want and all that. But we'll be bringing some of the coffee and treats back. We're already selling some soft drinks and stuff because we want this to be an open, welcome place that people can come and learn, read a book, hang out. Obviously, it's working because we've got a lot of people coming through the door today, which is awesome.
Yes, there are a lot coming in today.
Yeah,
but there's also reading spots in the store.
Yes.
There's a nook in the front where you can sit,
mm-hmm,
watch the train go by, and you can read a book. You can bring your kids in. There's a little place in the back for kids that is actually set up and encourages them to read, or you can read to them. And that's another thing. You're going to have people here to read to the kids, aren't you?
Right, we're going to have children's readings group. And then the other great thing is when we bring in authors, we plan on having an author author every Saturday night once we get things up and rolling to sign. They'll do author readings. So there's but particularly for children, we really want to make this a family stop so that, you know, young couples where the kids can come in, there's something for mom and dad, and there's something for, you know, for the kids as well. So
I think that's great.
And then with, you know, like Tony said, we've got a lot of experience in the industry between Frank and Tony and myself, and we have a lot of connections that, you know, if it, a writer can't figure out how to get started, we might be able to help them on that path to find someone that can publish their work. So
she started me on my path.
It's just neat how things go around in a circle. You know, when you help somebody, it comes full circle.
It does.
Absolutely.
I think it's important to help kids, or if you don't help others grow, then you'll have no place either, because if they don't make it, there's no reason for you to be there either.
Well, and I can tell you that me being here is the best compliment for Lynn and Frank, because, you know, I've been associated with them for both for years. And I was excited to be a partner. And that shows you how nice they are, because I would have gone nowhere near them if it hadn't been for that game. So these are good people.
Right. Well, I tell you, they all really get along well, and they're people-oriented. They love to see people come in the store. They love to take time with you. If you ever have questions about writing a book or teaching somebody how, helping them get started, these guys have all the tools that are here, so it's worth it. And they're going to be open.
New extended hours.
Oh, yes.
The store was closed Wednesdays and Sundays. We're now open 7 days a week. We're open from 10 to 4 Monday, 10 to 7 p.m. Monday through Thursday, 10 to 8 Friday and Saturday, and noon to 6 on Sundays.
Yep. So that's 7 days a week, so you can find them here. You know, one of them will be here. Now, are you all going to take turns being in the store, or how are you all going to work that?
Most likely, yes.
I have a feeling all three of you be here a lot.
Yeah.
At the same time.
Well, as much as we can. Frank right now, you know, since he's the one that has the bookstore ownership experience, he's the one that's here most of the time.
Right.
Organizing, getting our inventory the way we want and all that fun stuff. I'm here on weekends and helping out. Tony is like here all the time.
I like to hang out here. I like to hang out here before we became owners. And so, like today, I wasn't necessarily planning on being here, but we got a couple of hours, and Katie and I said, let's go to the store.
Yeah.
You know, and then we're just going to hang, you know, with my bros and my sis. You
it's
know,
your so. Home away from home.
That's right.
It this is.
You know, we're all going to be here just as much as possible, because, you know, we definitely want, you know, especially since we're trying to really do something a little different with the store.
Right.
That we want the experts here as much as possible. So.
And we want to tell the people listening, we want this to be your home away from home. So please come see us.
Oh, I think that's great. I mean, I enjoy it. When I come to town, I always come here. So this will be really neat. I'll have to change my routine. I'll probably have to come on a Saturday now. To be able to see everything. Now, is there anything else we need to make sure people know about Karen's Book Barn and the uniqueness about it and all the things that you've got going on and your upcoming events?
Well, like we said, we're going to try to have authors in every Saturday, but we're really, really pushing, trying to build our email lists so that we can push information out to everyone, too, and when we're having events, when we're going to have speakers in, so that people could be interested in that. But, I mean, you can visit our website, which is karensbookbarn.com, and sign up for our newsletter there so that we can give you information. But we're really also building our social media platforms, too, so, you know, they can find us on Twitter and Facebook, and I think Instagram.
But our first scheduled event that we have, Mary Ellen Choir, is going to be at the Farmer's Market on August 13th from 8 a.m. until 1 p.m. So stop by and see Mary Ellen there. And then we have others scheduled for September and October. So the other great thing is, because we're so well connected within the writers community, we've had a plethora of people asking, when can I have my book signing? So we will have no trouble filling our Saturday evening slots.
Right.
And so we're really looking forward to it.
Oh, I think you're all going to do great.
Thank you.
The community's going to benefit from all the knowledge you have to bring. You know, they bring their kids or bring themselves. If you got thoughts in your mind about a novel and you got the characters already figured out in your head and you just need a little nudge or a little help, they'll hold your hand. So,
and that's like Frank Hall, our third partner. And he has the magical touch in finding books. So, you know, after being a bookstore owner for so many years, the expertise he brings to Karen's Book Barn, you're just going to love coming here and shopping for books.
I think that's a neat thing to know, too, is that if you have a book in mind that you had when you were a kid and you can't find it or it's out of circulation, if you come in and tell Frank, he has places that he can go look and see if he can find that book, and you'll be more likely to find it. So that's a nice touch. So you have the research capabilities to do that. So.
Right.
Yep.
Well, this is wonderful. I'm so glad you guys were here today. That's great.
Thank you.
And I'm sure we're going to be back.
I'm sure you will be.
We'll be back. All right. Well, this is Debbie Crawford. Make sure you check out Karen's Book Barn in LaGrange, Kentucky.